Seat's done. I changed the seat belt in. Just took it off. Removed the sleeve from it. He wants the new ends from these on it. It should work just fine. I'll just have to cut this belt and put that end on it at the same length and slide that cover back over it. It should be good. He wants to use these buckles. The gray is not quite right, but I can pop that cap off and dye it a darker gray. I'll go ahead and do that for him. Alright. There it is, brand new end. Clean the plastic up good. Put a little Armor-All or Formula 2000. I like that better than Armor-All. It's not as greasy. Get it out there in the vehicle in a couple days. Let some heat get to it. She should be laid out real nice by then. Alright. Headliner. And the other seat be the next few things I'll do. Seat belts. Got one of them finished. Should be able to tell in the video. There's the old one. It's the old hardware. Got this one re-sleeved. It's got the new hardware. I have the cap off of it. It's a light gray. I'm gonna dye it a darker gray for him. One more seat belt. I may do the back ones for him too. See what they look like later. Alright, I'm working on the headliner now. I'm going to do tucked flames on it. I'll describe that process as I go. I'm filling in these areas. I've already glued these pieces. It's a 3/8 Landau foam. It's real dense foam. You can sand the edges. I've got it nice and flush on this one. I've got to sand this one still. Green background with gray flames coming from the front and back. Those are tucked. Something behind there. I did that, 12 years ago, maybe more. 10 years ago at least. 10, 12 years ago. It was in that truck there. Alright. We'll have something similar on this one. I'll be back with the next layer. Alright, we got the last layer of Landau foam on the headliner. I'm ready to make a stencil for the flame pattern, and I'll cut a groove. I'll have to show it step by step. So next step will be stencil the flames. Be back with it. Alright, I believe this is the flame pattern I'm going to run with. I got half of it, cut it out, flip it over, get the other half so it's the same. There they are, cut out. Can make a cool crown too. Crown of flames. We'll flip them over here with the other ones. I made a mistake in the past using an ink pen to trace these, but ink and then the vinyl we're going to put on here does not agree with each other. So we're going to use a pencil. Duh. Alright, next step on the headliner is to cut out the flames. Not really cut them out, but cut a line. The X-Acto knife. I've got half of it cut out.
I'll start one here and show you. I'll put my big head in the way. We're cutting down to the board, but not through the board, of course. The razor's a little dull. Couldn't find any new blades, I had to sharpen this one. I usually like doing this with a fresh blade. I'll cut through it like butter. If it drags, it'll rip it some. So we have a cut there, we're gonna end up gluing our material, the background material here, and tucking the edge into that groove we've just sliced with the razor. Same thing for the flame side. We'll tuck that end in there. Reason we're tucking it, because I cannot sew these two materials together due to the tips. You'd have ugly wrinkles, and only other way to do it is to continue the seam off the end of the flame, and it's still a pain in the butt. This is the best way I've found doing two different color flames. Or flame, and then the background different color. All right, I'll finish this out. I'll come back and show. I'll do the flame side first, which is going to be gray. What I'll end up doing, I have a piece of gray material already cut, big enough to the tip of the flame, big enough to hang over the front edge and the side edges. I'll end up spraying most of this with a glue gun, and when it comes to the flame tips, I'm going to take a paintbrush and brush the glue on it so I don't get any glue on this side. I'll show that next. Alright, got everything we need. Got our flame stencil, glue gun, paint brushes, and chalk. Gray material cut out, ready for the flame area. That's what we'll glue next. Alright, this will probably be a long clip. I'm going to start applying the glue to the headliner side. Flames themselves. I'm going to brush it up the tips of the flames and spray it on the larger area. The first time I did this, I taped up the whole background and sprayed all the glue. I found this a lot quicker. Having to take roll of masking tape and do all the tape work. I'll try to speak up. I got my camera really high, kind of out of the way. I don't have a lot of workspace here. I use what I've been given. Yeah, it's going to take a minute, so I either speed the film up or I may cut some parts out. I'll try to zoom in, show you at the end before I put the material on. Show you exactly how I applied it. Been better if I'd used some new brushes. I had to soak some in lacquer thinner to get them soft again, some old ones. Get these brushes for a dollar or two at Walmart, Home Depot. Just some little cheap brushes. The glue I'm using is Weldwood contact cement. It's used for Landau vinyl tops, trim. It's pretty much the same glue Factory uses on headliners and door panels. You apply the glue to both surfaces, let it dry for just a little bit, and when you put them together, it creates a bond. Done properly, it'll last up to 10 years or more. I was having a problem with this headliner shell. The yellow shell, Factory shell itself, is made out of probably 20 layers of tissue. So I started having some layers separating, not my glue that I glued the foam to the shell, but the shell itself starting to separate in layers. So hopefully he doesn't have a problem with this in the future. If so, it would probably be something of that nature. The only thing I could think for that is to purchase an aftermarket shell from Acme Headliner made out of ABS plastic. Cost a little bit more to do the job like that, but end up lasting longer. Yeah, I can already tell this is going to take a minute. What I'll end up having to do is get a good layer of glue on all this, spray it, go back over it, because it'll probably have dried too much. I mean, there is a drying point that's too far. Of course, you don't want it to be wet when you try to put the two items together. I'm going to get a layer on all my flame tips. I don't want to use up all my film space and battery life here. I'll be back. Alright, I messed up. I should have done half of this at a time. try my best not to let this touch. So I let it touch and pull it back up. I have to re-glue it. Next will be a fun part. Use our stencil, trace where the flames are. You can kind of see the indention, where they're glued, where they're not glued. Make sure all this vinyl's good and contacted with the foam. Heat will reactivate the glue too. If there's an air bubble or anything, I can take a heat gun and hopefully chance it to get it to stick back down, but we're good. No bubbles. Half of it's glue. Had a problem with my paint gun, glue gun sprayer earlier. It took me a while to get it to spray proper. Got new glue in it, cleaned it. We have came through though, triumphantly so far. Next will be the stencils. Alright, now I've came over here, I've found the tips of the flames by looking behind the vinyl. I've marked all the tips. I've marked the edges the best I can see. That way I can line my stencil up and trace where the edge is. So I'm gonna do that now. Come back after it's traced. Alright, got the flames all traced out. Now next is to cut excess material off. Of course the flames are going to be gray, so we need to cut anywhere from 3/8 to almost a half inch on the outside of our chalk mark, and that's going to tuck into the channel we cut with the razor blade. This is a very tedious, time consuming job, but it's very nice when it's done. It's worth it. So I'll do that now. Actually, again, I'm going to save battery life. I'm just going to trim it all the way out. All around the edge. Double, making sure to check as you cut. Make sure our chalk marks are in the correct area before you go to cut it. Just keep checking as we cut, little by little. If anything, cut more, and you can always trim later. Trim more off later. All right, real quick, battery's about to die. It's all trimmed out. I want to tuck half of this, let the battery charge, and I'll come back and show you how to tuck the other half. That way you can see the process and the finished product real quick. Probably take me a half an hour to tuck one side of it. Alright, got half of it tucked. I'm going to show you the other half here. Some of it. Already got that cut.
3/8, almost a half inch away from our groove we sliced in the foam. It's kind of an art to tucking it. I wouldn't say an art, a technique. Kind of roll it down in place. Get it as deep as you can. Here on, especially on deep curves, we want to do a little release slit. We're not going to cut all the way to the chalk though, we're going to go about halfway. Do that every half an inch around the curve. Hold this back. Sometimes I get a little glue on our channel that we cut, so I have to open that up again. Pull it back, tuck it, hold it up, pull it back, tuck it. The tool I'm using, it looks sharp. I've dulled the edges, so it's pretty round everywhere on it. You could use a putty knife if you want to do the same thing on it. Ideal thing to tuck with would be plastic, a bone tool, or hell, even a business card, a credit card or something. But I've used this tool for a long time, it's what I'm used to. Probably wouldn't recommend it for someone doing it for the first time. Work around to this tip, show you how I do my tips, and I'll probably cut to the next step. Hopefully everything I've showed you so far is enough to explain how to do this. Sorry for skipping around and cutting out on a few things. Such a long process, it would be a very long video if I had. I might have to make this headliner video a video by itself. I was gonna put the seats and everything to the whole interior all together on one video. Pull that out of the way.
I'll zoom in some so you can see more what I'm doing.
Hard to explain, just gotta get a feel for it. Just wanna work it down in the channel. Don't wanna force it and end up cutting or ripping the material. You could even do it, roll it with your fingers down in there almost. I've never even tried that. Look, it rolls halfway in there with your hand. Hey, I learn all the time, more and more I do this, I'm always learning better ways to do it. As long as it comes out right, there's not a wrong way to do it, I guess. I forgot we were zoomed in. Hope I didn't cover all of it up. ahead and do this tip. Look back right here at the tip of the flame. I'm going to poke a hole all the way through the headliner. Notice I've left a good inch and a half hanging from the tip, way more than I've left on the edges. I'm going to roll this back this way. I don't want to shove it from here, I'll just poke a hole in it. Put it right over that tip. I'm going to push the tip through that hole. Should have trimmed it some before I did that. I got ahead of myself. Alright, I did the rest of it all by my lonely with no camera. I hope I don't. I ain't gonna say it. Mess one thing up, I have to redo all of that. See how tedious this is. It'll be about $600 worth of work when it's done, but I charge about half that. And I don't know why. Make sure it's filming. Crazy then, I'd just be talking to myself. Guess I kind of am either way. A little wide, I'm gonna trim that. Thing on this tip and the curve. Cut some relaxing slits in the curve. Halfway. If we go all the way, we're going to see a little slit on the edge. We don't want to see a little cut mark. It'll ruin the whole thing in my eyes.
close to what I was talking about.
All right, I'll be back.
All right, it's all tucked. Ready for the background. But first, I'm going to finish my front edges. Flip it over. Could staple my tips down. Be all right, they're not going anywhere. So I'm going to spray these. Flip them over.
Cut back after that's done. Air compressor would be too loud.
Blue spray.
All this has trim covering it up anyways. I just like to fold, whether it's a normal headliner or a custom one, I fold the edges over. Make sure everything's held up as long as it can be. case I need to put some staples or anything. Halfway?
I got the flames all chalked out. My back's killing me from bending over this thing all day. So I'm gonna finish it up later or tomorrow. So till the next clip. Some of those lines are a little messy too. You can see where I was getting impatient and hurrying up. So I have to be careful when I cut those out tomorrow. We'll be cutting on the inside of these flames. Alright, till then.
Alright, about got half of it tucked here. That side's finished. Still have to trim this side. I'll make slits up the center. That way, as I trim close to our chalk mark, I can constantly check and make sure that chalk mark is on the correct line or lined up with it correctly. You don't want to cut too much. And I tuck going up to about the tip of the flame. I stop there and make sure I'm in the center where I'm cutting, then continue almost to the very tip. You can't quite go to the tip of the chalk mark. It won't tuck down on the edges. So if you noticed here, these are somewhat rounded off. So the flame actually continued up about a half inch further under that vinyl. But that's what you get. That's the final outcome. We'll come back and show it completely finished. And then installed. There it is, finished. I trimmed the visor holes and put this bad boy in the truck. I'll show it in the truck next. I would have cut the holes for the sun visors already. I had to go to the truck and test fit. He's got aftermarket TV sun visors going in it. They tend to not fit right, so I had to drill a couple holes. Be sure where my holes were in the headliner before I cut them, so everything looked like it'll line up fine. So I'll trim the holes and be back. Sewing up some new seat belts for the rear seats. There's the rear seats sewn together. I still have to put them together on the frames. So I've used all matching brand new seat belt material on all the seat belts. And I'll be back with the seats, everything installed except for the door panels. Beautiful day to put the seats in. Got the headliner and the rear seats installed. Steering wheel. Got the sun visor TVs. He's going to have all the plastic around all the back painted just like the outside of the truck. So that should look pretty sharp when that's finished. He's going to paint all of it up to where my green stops and then leave the plastic gray so that it flows with the headliner. It'll focus. Yeah. Yeah, I put a big gaudy clip. This painter's gonna have to do something with that clip there. Probably could have used new foam in there. That's good. All right, I'll get the front seats in. Quite the grass caught fire and went up on the truck. Good Lord, I need to cut my grass. I've been too busy working. Need to fix that. Poor thing. Got all the seats in. Gotta put the armrest on the driver's seat there. There. Color looks different on this camera. It's not that far off in real life here. Truck looks more blue on the film. Looks more green in person. Sharp truck. Alright, I'm gonna get those door panels done now. Door panel inserts. Gonna add the Landau foam. Door panel stripped. It's gonna have two layers of foam each panel. I've gotta come up with something for the bottom also. Usually the edge of the material tucks in here. This is an extremely wide channel, so originally I had carpet. Carpet was thick enough to tuck into that channel. The vinyl is going to be a lot thinner. I think I have to do a layer of this foam also. Do a design in it as well. First layer on this one's glued. I sanded all the edges. They're nice and round. I'm going to try to tone the edges down because it's going to be so thick after we get the second layer. So I'm going to sand the second layer down smooth too. That way our edges will fade away. I want just to be a big gobby square on the corners. So I'll get the other one, both of them, the first layer, and then I'll come back on the second layer. Alright, I got the second layer of foam, got the edges sanded smooth. flames traced on. That set's already cut. Have to cut this one. And we'll be gluing the gray flame area first, like on the headliner. Same process. First gray flame's done. Go ahead and do the next one. Got it tucked around here. I glue it over, put a couple little staples in it, and do the green background. And we just gotta figure something out for the bottoms of these. They're kind of scaring me. That's why I've saved them for last. Again, it would be no problem if this wasn't so thick. Alright, I'll be back with this one finished. Both gray flames done. Green background. Get that glued next. One insert finished. Working on a bottom piece. Hopefully this works out. I'm afraid I may have to cover over these. I thought he had a billet aluminum trim to where I could just cut a nice clean edge and then have him screw that over later. And I don't know if they make one for this truck or not. If they do, he could always cut it out later. And we'll see how it works out. I'm just going to top stitch the flames like the seats. Anyway, he's got a little bit of both worlds on the doors. The tucked and the stitching. Alright, I'll be back when I get this done. One bottom done. Still got to put some screws in that. I'll show that next. I'm going to finish up the other bottom in the meantime. I'll have to run to the hardware store to get some screws for the inserts. I went through a bunch of screws, found the right size I needed. That one there, so I'll take that one and get a bunch, just like it, and some washers. And finish that one. Alright, I'll be back.